I got another half hour till my Jeopardy audition. Oh, I've just got to see this. Oh, good. Here's a seat. Oh, this is going
to
be good.
Welcome back to the Honeymoon Game. Our distinguished panel from the press has finished posing their sweetheart questions to Vice President Cheney. Now let's bring out the president and see how well he can guess what his vice president answered. Are you ready, Mr. President?
Well, shoot, I guess I am. I mean, I'm the president, aren't I?
Okay. Did Mr. Cheney think Russia would be a bosom buddy or a naughty neighbor?
I have heard of Russia, and as an American, as the president of the Americas, or North America, or whatever, I'm sure that I will have Secretary of State Powell look into that.
Let's see what the vice president did answer.
Aw, damn it, Georgie, that's not an answer.
Oh, but Mr. Cheney, that's how you taught me.
Oh, don't be such a ninny, boy. Just once.
Why don't you two keep that squabbling inside the Lincoln bedroom? Let's see the card. Our judges say that's not a match. Let's go to our panelists for a response.
I was impressed that he appeared to even comprehend the question.
Yes, and while he could have made lewd jokes about the Russian premier, he instead chose to behave with true diplomatic aplomb.
Not to mention genuine bipartisanship-ness.
Excuse me? He didn't say anything. I suppose we should give him a Nobel Prize every time he avoids making a complete ass out of himself?
Now there's an idea.
Hey, threatening the president is a federal crime.
I didn't threaten him. All I said
That's enough. You've been warned.
How'd he get on the panel?
Must have been affirmative action.
Figures.
Moving on. When it comes to deficits, the blanker, the better.
Come on, Georgie. This is an easy one.
Don't worry, Mr. Cheney. I got this one. Let's see. I have heard of the deficit. We've all been talking about it quite a lot. And that's why I plan on having Mr. O'Neill count it for me just as soon as he can.
Oh, Christ, Georgie. You're gonna kill me.
Is he okay?
Oh, don't worry. This happens all the time. Come on, Mr. Cheney. We've got to finish the game.
I'm okay. No, I'm not.
Once again, I'm afraid we have a miss.
Hey, I got a question.
Question time is over.
Tough. President Bush? Oh, damn, that's painful to say. Anyway, with the wealthiest Americans already paying a declining share of taxes, how can you justify your tax cuts, which will lessen their share even further?
Look out! A hardball question!
Quick, where's that Secret Service guy?
I think I saw him backstage.
An attempt on the president. I'm right on it. Oh, about all this. Do you think this makes my ass look fat?
Let me go!
Hooey! Everybody just calm down. I can handle it. You see, the rich Americans who have made all the money off of other Americans are the ones who deserve to get back some of that hard-earned money that those other Americans work so hard to make. Which is why I want to make the pile bigger. Because I know what it means to put food on your family.
Huh? What the hell was that he just said?
Once again, not really an answer at all. So let's lose the penguin and go on to our last question. When it comes to missile shields, who cares if it works? Just as long as it's blank.
Oh, I really know this one. See, we need a big missile shield, like one of them Star Wars thingies, so we can take care of business, like Americans always have. Like at the OK Alamo Corral, or Luke Skywalker, or whatever. And that's why I got this here nuclear football. See, all I got to do is push this red button here like this, and then...
La, this looks, how you say, not so good.
Well, what do our panelists in the media honeymoon booth think of that?
Well, clearly, that was part of the president's carefully crafted long-range foreign policy strategy.
He's always thinking, that president of ours.
That's the honeymoon spirit. Well, that's all the time we have. From all of us here, good night.